My full name is Matthew Cumar Merrill Morison, and this is my fifth year at the university, and I'm completing 2 4-year degrees, BSc, with a double major in mathematics and physical geography. I had a chance to work with Dr. Danny Blair for 2 summers, who's now, I guess, the Associate Dean of Science, and he's definitely sort of been an inspiration in terms of his passion for his work and the multitude of things that he's able to do and deal with. So having him as sort of a mentor figure for me was pretty inspiring, and taking a class with him, and yeah, he's really helped me sort of develop academically and personally, and to become passionate about academia in a sense. Yeah. For 2 years I had a chance to work with Dr. Danny Blair, but last summer as well I was working in Churchill, Manitoba, as well as York Factory, Manitoba, up north, collecting data for a thesis I'm completing this year, and with Dr. Leanne Fishback, an adjunct with the Department of Geography. And something really neat is the collaboration between the Churchill Northern Studies Center and the Department of Geography are here. They do a lot of work together, and like a field course is run out of Churchill every few years within the department, as well as hosting students there to do either work as a research assistant or collecting data for a thesis. I was in York Factory, York Factory National Historic Site, collecting hydrologic groundwater data for a thesis on modeling. It's part of a preservation project. They're trying to save one of the oldest historic sites in Canada. One thing that really interests me, and one opportunity in specific that I have been researching a little bit into, is the field of climate modeling and building up climate models so that they can run a little more efficiently, because that's one of the largest problems is having the computing power to sufficiently to run a climate model to get enough information from it in a reasonable amount of time, and from computing power, like one of the most powerful computers in the world is dedicated specifically to climate modeling. So it's neat that there's such an interest in it, and to make the process more efficient and a little more accessible, and to be able to sort of put more power behind it, is obviously increasingly important given the influence of anthropogenic climate change in terms of risks to our society, and like personally getting a chance to go up north where perhaps it will be hit the hardest as a result of that is sort of a little bit of an effect on me, but to be able to see that and then have a chance to work on it.